Rufus ain't coming.
You deal with me. I don't know you.
Selling, G. Something in there you like?
Not much. A detective, no less. Affirmative action, right?
Ain't the Supreme Court a bitch?
In recognition of extraordinary contributions to our community, I take great pride in presenting Detective Anita Wellman King. With his meritorious duty commendation this 21st day of November, 1992. So where now?
Violent crimes.
Violent crimes? That's Mulligan's game.
Can you get me in or not?
Maybe. 10 deep in patties and Pollocks. What happened to you as black woman of the 90s doing on our own?
Hey, how are we doing on that Polish Hill variance, T?
Hey, you get it, Jerry. Tell the councilman I promise, okay? We're in violent crimes.
Homicide.
Black female homicide? Louis Farrakhan will be Grand Wizard of the Ku Klux Klan before the Mixon homicide lets you off traffic fatalities.
Do you have the juice, or don't you?
Sergeant Chimaka.
I'm back.
In the back.
Sergeant Chimaka.
Yeah.
King, division sent me over. I've been assigned to your shift.
You boys aren't busy. I got an 80-year-old decomp looking for a primary at the gardens. Thank you. No need to sit. You're not going to be here that long.
Paretsky!
All right. This is a murder book. You get a homicide, we start a murder book. Your name goes here. Victim's name goes on the cover in red. Victim's name stays in red till the case goes down. Then it goes over here in black. The book goes down to the DA. And the...
Koretsky!
End of the month, you've got more black murder books than red. I get you a permanent parking space. End of the month, you've got more red... Hello? End of the month, you've got more red books than black, like Koretsky here. You find yourself writing...
Parking tickets from the driver's seat of the subcompact.
King Koretsky.
Oh, yeah, I saw your picture in the paper.
Detective King's been assigned at a shift. You're gonna be her training officer. That's it. Why don't you go get yourself a cup of coffee? It's in the back there. You're out of regulation plainclothes again. You're not on the corner anymore making buys wear skirt.
I got knobby knees. Come on. You know I work better with men.
Broaden your horizons. What? She's got juice downtown. Her orders came from Mulligan's office.
She's out of internal affairs. Give it to Kanaski. You're delaying me.
I gave her to you.
That's my home phone. If my wife answers, just hang up.
I got a friend over at the Midtown Inn. Let us have a room for a couple hours.
Hey, did anybody watch the Thomas hearings?
No, thanks.
I'll throw in a couple of sodas.
What part didn't you understand? The N or the O? You got a sign on your back. Oh. Brannigan's handiwork. The sloppy one looks like an unmade bed. Kanaski over there is the good-looking one. Wyatt Earp over there is Delaney. What are you looking for? We work as partners. One primary investigator on each case, one secondary to back her up. If you're the primary, the victim goes up under your name. If you're the secondary, you help out as much as you can. Okay, what'd you do? If you smeared super glue on anything over here again, Brannigan, I swear to God, I'm gonna super glue your butt to that chair. That was fun.
You want to borrow my super glue?
What are you grinning about? Okay. I'm looking for a guy named Rufus. Probably a drug dealer. This is my desk. I had to wait 4 months for this desk.
Bretsky, line two, you're up.
I'm working on Rufus.
You got the virgin.
Where is it, the hill? Where are you? Brandon Martin Luther King.
That's a tough break.
Polish Hill. Terrific. Were you on a stakeout last night? Your clothes. What about my clothes? Do you always dress like that? Like what? Nothing. Want me to drive? Don't break it now. We decide who's primary investigator and who's secondary investigator before we arrive at the scene. And since this took place on the hill, on the corner of Grand and Martin Luther King Boulevard, a well-known neo drug market, and being that this is your first day, I say you're the primary. Yo. What are you doing in homicide anyway?
I'm in my shop.
Doing what? Busting cops in internal affairs? I broke my butt getting up here, and now I gotta compete with a black political appointment from the mayor's office?
Look, nobody took the exam for me, and my being black happens to be beside the point.
We've got a black mayor and a black police commissioner. Now you tell me who's gonna end up in traffic if they want one woman in homicide.
How many black lieutenants do we have, Black captains? 4 out of 93. Because people like you are holding it up.
You don't want to work with me? Fine. From the looks of that book, you're not exactly J. Edgar Hoover. They stick me with the crap to keep my clearance rate down.
All you have to do is show me the job. You don't want to? It's okay by me. I'll figure it out myself.
You're still the primary.
Yaphet Taylor. I seen them hanging around with a kid named Malik. They're dealers.
Check his pockets for ID and watch out for needles. This Malik kid around?
I ain't seen him.
Lots of holes. Close range rifle, probably. So someone was sure peeved at all your fit. Nothing in front. Wait for the coroner to flip him.
You got a shooting gallery out here. You got some dealers in the one in the corner. That's a squad for crackheads. There might be some real people in that stone one with the green awning.
Occurred across the street. A boy named Yafet was killed. Did you or any member of your household witness anything?
Good riddance to bad rubbish, all I got to say. If you all came around every once in a while before they got shot instead of after, maybe folks be more talkative. Now get out of here before my Bobby come home and kick your behind.
Bobby gonna kick your behind.
No, Bobby's gonna kick your behind.
So what do you think?
I think you're one step closer to writing parking tickets.
Let go, please.
Yafet Taylor, 16, black, known before his untimely death as Money, to his closest friends and innumerable pharmaceutical customers, known from this day forward to our newest AAB as her first case.
Yeah.
What's AAB? Affirmative Action Baby.
Detective King is over from Internal Affairs, so those of you still moonlighting as bagmen for the Cambrucci family might want to arrange your drops outside the building from now on. Yeah. Yafet had a crime partner named Malik. King's got a mugshot on Malik. Anybody run across him, let King know. Paretsky, any luck finding this Rufus?
Ballistics came back with a .45. No ID on either body.
All right, let's help her out, people. Rufus is a material witness in a double murder. Nobody likes the bad guys shooting at cops. That's it. Let's go. Got a court notification for you.
Brannigan, I got a lot of work to do today. Just tell me what you did so I can get it over with.
Fretzky, you're not the center of my universe. I was busy this morning.
Excuse me. Excuse me. You're the one supposed to be looking after my boy.
don't even know who I am, do you? My boy gets shot down in the street yesterday, and you were supposed to come talk to me?
Miss Taylor, I'm Detective King. I'm handling
the
investigation.
You are all the same. Don't nobody give a damn.
We tried to find you yesterday after the
I don't need nothing from you. Come on, Ramirez.
Mrs. Taylor,
we'll find him. You know, I figured that maybe you would have been different, but I guess I figured wrong. Come on!
That was fun.
Moretti, you're out line four!
Oh, come on, you gotta be kidding me!
Line four!
Sarge, please?
Pick it up!
Yeah, where are you? The hill. Of course you are. What? It's not funny. Angel Street and 39th. Projects. When the hell am I gonna have any time to work on Rufus? So drop it. Two red murder books with my name on it? So don't drop it. I think that this Malik kid's gonna be pretty easy to find. What do you think the chances are that he was Yaphet Taylor's killer?
We were talking about Rufus.
All right, what about the victims? The two guys in the bathroom, they give you any leads?
Out-of-town deals from St. Louis. I'm waiting for info over the wire.
What the fuck's this Rufus guy anyway? Is he the victim or is he one of the shooters?
The killer was screaming the name Rufus at the top of his lungs the whole time that he was shooting at me. That's all I got.
Detective King, right?
Yeah.
Bill Llewellyn, homicide. I'm sorry I missed saying hello yesterday. I was in court. Listen, I'm sure they're giving you a hard time. And I wish there was something I could do about it. But, you know, that's how it is when you're new.
I'll pull through.
Listen, I gotta run. I'm doing court. Can I buy you a drink? Dinner? Tonight, maybe?
I'm involved with someone.
Oh, that's too bad. Well, let me know if you change your mind.
These guys. Come on, you seem nice.
Yeah, his wife thinks so, too.
You're from homicide?
Why do you guys keep asking that? Where's the body?
No body. Doesn't sound right.
No body.
Miss Donnelly? Miss Donnelly?
She didn't come home yesterday. I didn't know what to do. She always comes home. She's good about it.
Who didn't come home?
Her daughter.
What's her name?
Spencer.
Is the father home?
He don't live here no more.
Could she have gone to visit her father? And what about boyfriends? Could she be with a boyfriend?
She's not. I called you people yesterday. Nobody came. Why'd it take 2 days, huh? Because I live in the projects? Because I'm poor? You don't give a damn.
You'll need to file a missing persons report, Miss Donnelly. Do you have a recent photograph?
Yeah. She's all I got to live for.
She's very pretty. We'll find her. I promise. Missing person says uniforms handing out the flyers.
That's all we're gonna do.
Well, homicide. No body, no investigation. Thanks, huh?
How much do we owe you?
Just forget about it.
It's free coffee. It's no big deal.
It is to me. Here you go.
Thank you. You got the good citizenship merit badge in Girl Scouts, right? Couple of lousy flyers. That's the best we can do. All right, all right.
Order up the known sex offenders living around Spencer's apartment. When we get a couple extra minutes, which we won't, we'll poke around, okay?
Thank you.
Gonna help me look for Malik?
Monyo looks pretty much like the rest, but what the hell, huh?
What's with you and this yo thing?
As in yo, what's up?
Yeah, I know what it means. But if you were referring to blacks, why don't you just say black?
You wouldn't prefer Afro-American?
I would prefer man, woman, child. You know, do you do this to get under my skin, or are you really a biscuit-head, neo-Nazi, inbred Charlie redneck?
Why don't you come by the house next week? I'm having a couple neighborhood boys over for a David Duke fundraiser. Slow up, right side.
Hey, Malik! Might we have a word with you, my man? He's running. What a surprise. Don't make us get out of the car, Malik. I get really unhappy when I gotta get out of the car. You running those heels? Stop, Malik! He's just a sucker! What the hell are you doing? Take the back!
Take the back!
No, you! Take the back!
Have a word with you, my man?
Who is that? That stop crap with your gun. We want the guy for questioning. What were you gonna do, shoot him?
He annoyed me.
Yeah, I annoy you. You gonna shoot me too?
I haven't decided yet.
Hey!
Hey, let's hit it! Oh, come on.
Hey, damn it! The radio. Did they get my purse?
What good your gun's gonna do you in the car?
Hey, I'm not the one that left the door open.
We're in pursuit of a murder suspect, and you're in pumps in a skirt.
So what do my clothes have to do with anything?
Save the Jessica Hall and look for the boys down at Division. You want to work your way up on your back? Do it on your own time.
Okay, now look. You don't know me. You don't know a damn thing about me. So why don't you just shut up?
What? All right, get in. No fleas, okay?
You gonna drive or what?
We really are a biscuit head Polak, Paretsky.
Okay. Can we go now?
What are you doing down here anyway? You don't give a damn about these people.
I grew up on this hill, King. Right down on Angel Street. This is my neighborhood. And this was a great place to live.
Until we moved in and ruined everything, right?
Well, I don't see you living down here, contributing to the Afro-American community.
I did my time in a neighborhood like this, South Side.
You gotta be kidding me. The South Side?
Yeah.
I had you figured for a North Hills High or Wheaton. You know, one of those places you people run to as soon as you get two nickels you can rub together.
This isn't your neighborhood anymore. This isn't your city anymore. So you get on the back of the bus or get the hell out of the way, all right? What are you smiling at?
Are you finished?
Yeah, I guess.
Then let's go.
Spencer Donnelly doesn't really have a chance. 17 child molesters in the four block area surrounding Spencer's apartment. Can you believe this?
Is this a great city or what? Can we go now? Even the dog is freezing.
Mm-mm. Malik will be back out. Man's gotta make a living, right?
The Yaphet Daly case is not going down.
His name's gonna be in that book in big red letters till the day he retired.
Poe in black, right, Paretsky?
Meaning what?
Meaning you'd care if it was a white kid killed in the parking lot of a supermarket out on Brewster Avenue, instead of a black kid named Yaphet gunned down on the corner of Grand and King Boulevard.
You saying I don't do my job?
I'm saying blacks killing blacks is viewed by whites as inexpensive population control. I'm saying black life is cheap.
Hey! This is not a race thing. I care about my job. You're the one just passing through homicide on your way to lieutenant's bars.
Yeah, I'm ambitious, so what? I want to make captain, you don't?
Not really. I can understand you wanting to leave internal affairs, but why homicide?
Why can you understand my wanting to get out of internal affairs?
Because internal affairs is for paper shufflers and climbers.
And where'd you come up?
Narco. What?
Narco happens to be the dirtiest division in the city. Who is your partner?
Frank Harding. Harding was a good cop.
And why is he doing time?
Yo, Malik, what's up?
Yo, here it is, man.
Is that what you want?
Remember me? Turn around. Take it!
Why y'all sweating me? I ain't done nothing.
We're investigating the shooting death of Yaphet Taylor.
Who?
Yaphet Taylor. You lived across the street from him for 9 years. You own a 30-06 hunting rifle, Malik?
Yeah, yo, what you trying to say? I get my boy. Is that what you're trying to say?
Who did?
I didn't see it go down.
So far, I haven't decided whether to bust your ass for making my partner here ruin a perfectly good pair of $15 pantyhose.
I saw the wheels. They was gold-like. They was fat. It was on a Camaro or a Firebird.
Who owns it?
Can we hurry this up? I gotta go to the bathroom.
That's it?
That's it?
That's all you got. Let's run this punk in. What do you think?
I say let's do it.
Let's do it!
Hold up, hold up! Damn! The girl must have seen it. The weird one up in the window.
What window?
She be watching us day and night like she the FBI. Across from the corner, the Stone House.
Bobby gonna kick your behind.
Wait.
Homicide, do you have a little girl living here, sir?
Yes.
May we see her?
Yes, come on.
Thank you.
She can't get around on her own, but we put her over there, and she likes it. She likes seeing everything, what's going on.
We're investigating a shooting that occurred across the street. A boy was killed.
Oh, she can't talk. She just sits there. She writes, though, a little.
Did you see the shooting? Come on, let's go. Even if she did see it, we'd never be able to use her in court. Come on. A why? Does that mean yes?
That means yes.
Did you see who did it? Did you see the car? Was it a gold car? Honey, can you describe them?
Bobby? Bobby, you home?
Up here with the police.
The police?
Ma'am,
listen.
Baby,
are you okay?
Ma'am.
Are you okay?
A boy was murdered. Don't you think you should help us find his killer?
She got shot down there. And you all didn't do a thing about it. Playing on our own sidewalk. Not one damn thing. So don't be lecturing me about what I should or shouldn't be doing.
White? Were they white? The killers were white. Now do you care? Kids decide to bust out and rip off a dealer. They grab Daddy's deer rifle and use our YFET as a rifle range.
White kids in that neighborhood.
Whites are in and out of the hills 24 hours a day,
by 237 gold Camaros and Firebirds in the Tri-County area. It'll take us months to track them all down.
Well, we've narrowed it down to white drug users.
Mm-hmm. Nice pants.
Thanks. We still have no tread marks, no physical descriptions of the suspects. What are we hoping for here? That if we ring the right doorbells, the murderer will get on his knees and confess?
Well, you got a better idea?
Where's my desk? I am getting sick of this.
Join him at the roll call for a couple of beers.
And you'll go?
Hell yeah, I'll go. I'll even buy.
Thank you.
I got a good job here. I ain't dealt nothing in 2 years.
Nobody asked. That's quite a shiner. Behind on your car payments?
I fell on the stairs.
Have you seen your daughter in the last few days, Mr. Donnelly?
Her mother won't let me near her.
Are you upset about how little time you're able to spend with Spencer?
What the hell's going on?
Spencer's missing. We're trying to find her. You don't seem too surprised.
I love my daughter.
So you haven't seen her?
Ask Glory. Ask her why she's living in the projects with a bunch of niggers coming in and out, huh? You ask her if she's still married to a pipe. Hey, ask her about that.
Niggers live there, Mr. Donnelly. They have to come in and out.
Are you insinuating that your wife has a drug problem?
Yeah, you could insinuate that.
And I wonder where she picked up that habit. Maybe if you're dealing for a living?
Hey, Negro lady policeman. She was a pillhead long before she met me, all right?
You know, I do believe that I've noticed some white powder on your jacket, requiring me to handcuff you right here in your place of employment and take you downtown for a nice lengthy cavity search. How about
that, Mr. Donnelly? Thank you for your cooperation, Miss Donnelly. If you hear from Spencer, you let us know, okay?
No account, rubberneck, pinhead!
Cavity search? That's some temper you got there, King. What set you off, Negro? Or maybe it was Lady Policeman.
I haven't used in over a year.
That's not what your husband says.
Yeah, well, he's a lying bastard. Look, I had a habit, okay? Did a lot of things I'm not proud of, but I'm straight. You can ask the lady at Social Services. I got a job. They threatened to take her away, you know? I couldn't let them take my kid away. She's the best thing that ever happened to me.
What about your husband, Miss Donnelly? Could he have taken her?
Maybe. I don't know.
Anybody else? A family member? Grandparents?
You gotta find her. I can't make it without her. Please.
So Spencer comes out of school and starts for home. Now, what'd that Coley kid say? They always went north on Frick?
Yeah.
So who we got for sex offenders up this way?
We got three. Spurgeon, Martin, James Carubian.
You know this girl?
You have three prior convictions for child molestation.
20 years ago, yeah. One of them was only endangerment.
Only?
Gotta keep working, okay?
So you don't know Spencer Donnelly?
Lots of kids around here.
You willing to come in for some questioning?
You mean I got a choice?
Makes things easier.
I'll think about it.
This where we can find you when we need you?
For the last 13 years.
Missing persons come up on anything at Spencer yet?
No. But I think it's the father. He's definitely up to something.
Oh, and that newspaper guy isn't? I bet he collects side panels from milk cartons like baseball cards.
Probably gonna paste it up all over his refrigerator.
Why don't we bring Daddy Dearest down here for a little informal chat about Spencer? Want me to call him?
I think we should go back to the Alpha Tail Trans Am tomorrow and see if the DMV's come up with anything new.
Who put this on my desk?
Bathing victims from the Rufus case. Seems they got names and faces. Drug convictions, attempted murder. One had a sister he was in contact with.
Where are you going?
They were registered at the Vagabond Hotel downtown. Let's go.
They still got stuff up in their room?
Yeah, they paid in advance. Haven't been in any trouble. Got another couple of days paid for.
Maybe we can get the evidence techs down here, round up some latent prints or something.
What'd these guys do?
They died.
No kidding. Dead, huh?
Jeez, you see Ma broke up about it.
Your friend, no. The big guy, the one staying here with him.
You got a name, a description?
6465. Got a funny name.
Rufus? Daily maid service, huh? This big guy been around?
I'll take the stairs.
All over me.
I think he may have cracked the rib.
Oh, man, guacamole. I hate guacamole. This is not funny.
I'm sorry.
How am I gonna get this out?
Maybe we can go back to the hotel, see if he bought any chips.
It's not funny. I can't afford this dry cleaning. All right, it's a little funny.
Thanks for coming down, Mr. Donnelly. Fall down some more stairs, Larry?
I'm clumsy.
Yeah, well, you're also broke. Gotten a 2-week advance on your salary at work, and you've asked for a loan. You've overdrawn your credit cards, buying 3 VCRs, 2 TVs, 4 washer and dryer sets, stereos, microwaves, and the gas range. What, are you planning on opening your own appliance store?
Aren't you out looking for my kid instead of rousting me in my lunch hour?
And you've written 16 bounced checks. If check and fraud weren't backed up 2 months, you'd be sitting in the tank down the hall right now.
So arrest me, then.
I think you owe somebody a lot of money. Mr. Donnelly, if this has anything to do with your daughter's disappearance, now's the time. We can help.
I've got to get back to work.
She's only 9, Mr. Donnelly.
I know how old she is. Look, I love Spencer, but this don't have nothing to do with her, all right? So just get out of my face, lady.
Watch out for those stairs, huh?
Happy birthday to you.
Hey, girls, want a piece?
We're not girls, Kanaski. We're women.
Take a mite off, Bretsky. Come on,
why is it when a woman says something direct to a man, they think you got PMS?
I want the ovulation envy.
Koretsky? King? Who's the grease monkey?
Larry Donnelly. The victim's father in the Spencer Donnelly case.
Really? Am I missing something? Did somebody find a body while I was at lunch?
No, sir.
No, sir. You don't have enough to do on Yaphet Taylor without picking up stray cats. And you've got 7 cases on the shame sheet, all unsolved. If you two want to work missing persons, put in transfer requests. Please. Please.
That was fun. Go through that Yaphet Taylor file again?
Mm.
What about the autopsy report?
They shot him a lot.
Damn it!
already nailed my coat to the wall.
My wife gave me this coat.
It wasn't me.
This is Warnock, Pesky. I hope you know that. I was going easy on you before, you being a girl and all.
It wasn't me, Brannigan. Honest.
You're dead, Pesky. Dead.
Great. Fantastic. Every case is dead end, and now Brannigan's going to spend all of his time trying to make my life miserable. What else can go wrong?
Pesky, line four!
No way. Nope. No, no. Look at Kanaski. Zip in 2 weeks, not a single new case.
He's been in court.
Well, he's not in court today.
You can't cut it here, Pesky. Inform division. They'll find you a job with an easier caseload.
What do you got against me, Chamaco?
Here. See this file? Transfer requests. Guys trying to get into homicide. Good men. Good cops. Some have been waiting for years. And why should you get their shot, huh?
I'm a good cop.
Yeah, well, you'd be a better cop with 5 more years in plain clothes.
I did my time in narco.
What, 4 years in uniform, a couple in narco? Every man up here has a minimum 10 years in. And what are you, 28, 29? The only reason you're up here is a federal judge. I'm not a Neanderthal. I am not against women. But I am for the most qualified cop getting the shot. You're not it. Line four.
Homicide.
You remember seeing a beeper on Yafet's body? The coroner lists a beeper on Yafet's personal effects.
Beeper?
Uh-huh.
Hold on, please. Let's go.
What's this?
The telephone, Kanaski. Something you haven't picked up since the day I arrived.
Hey. Homicide.
Ramir, is that Yafet's beeper? Your mom told us she gave you Yafet's beeper. Did you use it yet?
No, man, he just profiling. Just walking back and forth and showing off his hip.
Did you clear it?
How you do that?
No way we could be this lucky.
Number from the beeper.
What the hell is the phone doing way out here in Lakeside Village?
Maybe Yafet's stockbroker beeped him with a tip.
Damn it. Why does this keep happening to us? Would you mind giving me a ride home? My brother's got my car.
Mm-mm. Let's go.
You live on Polish Hill?
Mm-hmm. My grandfather. He don't want to move. I look out for him, he looks out for my kid.
You have a kid?
Yeah, so what?
Nothing.
Can I use your bathroom?
Forget it. It's all right.
Nah, it's okay. Come on.
Nope, it's all right.
It's okay. Come
no,
on.
No, no, it's all right.
It's okay.
Mm.
watching.
Mr. Chorno.
We work together. How's Jennifer? She okay? No Jimmy, huh? You want a drink? Come on. You haven't used the bathroom yet? It's right down there. She's beautiful. You married? Divorced. None of my business, right?
Right.
The language your grandfather was speaking was Polish. He didn't seem too comfortable with my being here.
He doesn't like colors in the house. It's just the way things are. You know that.
Bobby's okay.
Hey. Why don't you leave me the Yaphet Taylor file?
Your boyfriend? You're sleeping with the deputy mayor? No kidding, you're connected downtown.
We keep our professional and personal lives very separate. If anything, it has made me work harder.
Oh, yeah. No doubt. Nice house. His, I bet.
What do you want, Paretsky?
The Yaphet Taylor file? I went back through the gold Camaros and Firebirds. Looked for addresses out near that payphone at Lakeside Village.
There weren't any, we checked.
Right. But who else uses Lakeside Village?
We checked all the surrounding communities.
Who else uses Lakeside Village since they closed the East Side Bridge for repairs?
Brunswick. Who's in Brunswick?
There's only one. Mulligan. Daniel Sean Mulligan. Deputy Chief of Police and Head of Violent Crimes. You're gonna wanna run with this one, Girl Scout? Another Camaro or Firebird within 10 miles. Look at the rap sheet on this kid. Patrick Kenneth Mulligan, DUI, shoplifting, drunken, disorderly, trespassing, possession.
Typical white teenage male. It's a
big leap to leveling off a deer rifle in Yafet's chest and squeezing off 5 rounds.
6 arrests. Not one went to trial.
Mulligan sure looks out for his own.
Cops look out for their own.
Come or stay. It's up to you.
Patrick, right?
You looking for my dad?
Nice wheels.
He's at the track.
He didn't get to go?
Yeah, my brother Danny's now from school this week, so he took him.
Is this your car or your brother's car?
Well, it was his. Now it's mine.
You the only one who drives it? You like the outdoors? Hunting? Fishing?
So your dad's at the track, huh? Okay, we'll catch up with him there.
Coming down this stretch, K9.
Chief of police, all we've got is a number on a beeper and his kid Patrick looking nervous.
What, you worried about your career?
You're damn right.
You're not? We ask a couple questions, it's our job.
Ooh, I have to say, I told you so. I'm on a roll,
Jimmy. The day is young, the day is young. God!
Oh, too bad you won't.
God!
What'd I tell you, Jimmy?
Captain Mulligan? Captain Mulligan?
Yeah, what?
Paretsky, King, homicide.
Hey, Jimmy! Jimmy, a couple of yours.
Oh, man. Doherty. This guy runs homicide.
Here, Danny, come on. Put $20 on number 7, huh? Let's go. Paretsky?
Actually, sir, we're here to see Captain Mulligan.
We have reason to believe that your gold Firebird was involved in a drug-related homicide on Tuesday.
Who was killed?
A boy named Japhet Taylor.
Black?
He was shot 5 times at close range with a hunting rifle.
What reason to believe?
2 witnesses saw a gold Camaro or Firebird.
Anybody ID the plates?
No, sir. But a beeper found on the victim led us to a telephone booth in Lakeside Village. And the only Camaro or Firebird in the area is registered to Captain Mulligan.
Did it ever occur to you that just about anybody could drive to Lakeside Village?
Yes, sir. It occurred to me.
What kind of hunting rifle?
.30-06 slugs.
I don't want to read about this in the paper tomorrow. You got it?
Yes, sir.
Paretsky?
Yes, sure, hey. Whatever.
Take a leak. That's it. That's it.
Police emergency, ladies and gentlemen. Sorry, buddy, you'll have to wait right there. Police emergency, man, let's go. Move it out. Come on, move it. Move. Clear it out. Let's go.
Back of the line. Ladies, it's all yours. Come on. There you go.
How does it feel, boys?
You can hold it, can't you? As soon as all these ladies are out, you can go back in. Have a nice day. Together for 2 years.
Who?
The kind of thing gets around, it can be very damaging.
It's none of my business.
Look, you're a woman. People always want to think the worst. Nobody wants to believe that a woman can get ahead on her own merits.
Her merits. Right.
Thurman and I have a very committed relationship. He cares about my career, he supports my goals, but I've done the work. I earned it. If he hadn't gotten involved, Division never would have given a black woman a shot in homicide. Uh-huh. You're not gonna make this easy, are you? That's what I thought. Any messages from Dougherty or Mulligan's office?
Hello.
Are you kidding? This phone isn't gonna ring.
Uh-huh.
Mulligan's not gonna drop a dime on him. That's great, Brannigan. Detective Brannigan.
Somebody put a rubber in my coat pocket. My wife found it. Wondered what I needed it for. Wondered loudly. Used some flying wedding china to emphasize her dismay.
Brannigan, I swear to God it wasn't me.
Don't look at me.
Here's your pal, Rufus. I rousted one of my stoolies. You're a cop. I don't like people shooting at cops.
Oreski, line two!
I'll take it, Sarge. You. You are a dead woman, King. Dead.
Shaking in my boots, Brannigan.
He nails coat to the wall, too?
Online partner, nigger. You got that? You got that?
Both crazy bitches.
Call an ambulance. It'd be a shame if old Ruby's here bled to death before spending the next 25 years bending over for the soap upstate. Ruddy in Latin.
So when's the hospital gonna let us talk to him?
He's still in post-op. Guess we messed up his leg, but it's good. Tough break.
Oreski, line two.
Quitting time, Sarge.
It's Delaney out in Adams County. That missing little girl case you're not supposed to be working on. We found a body.
Oreski. Right.
Connolly.
Oh, no.
Not the daughter. The father.
It's Donnelly, all right. I got the call, but I knew you two were already working on his daughter's kidnapping.
These trucks come from all over the city, right?
The bulldozer operator found the body when he was leveling out.
Shot him once in the forehead with a large caliber weapon. Probably a .45.
Do you think the killer was holding Spencer for ransom, trying to get Dad here to pay up? I hope not. Because if he was, how long is he going to keep her alive now? We need a search. The entire area.
What are we looking for?
A little girl. And let's hope to God we don't find her.
Maybe the kidnappers have just turned Spencer loose. Well, maybe Donnelly was telling the truth and his death isn't connected to her disappearance.
All right, we can hunt up his old crime partners, dealers. Maybe he was back in business and ripped him off.
Would you keep Spencer alive after you've killed her father?
They kidnapped her for ransom. Now they'll let her go.
Unless she can ID them.
Maybe she can't.
Well, if we're gonna find her, we better make it quick. Before they make up their minds.
Paretsky. King. Upstairs.
I've been looking through your Yaphet Taylor file. You can't take this to the grand jury.
We haven't had an opportunity to interrogate our prime suspect
yet. You don't have a prime suspect. You have suppositions, and weak suppositions at that.
Thank you, Jimmy. You know, Jimmy and I, we came up together. He was a sergeant when I got my first command down on Polish Hill. You're from Internal Affairs, aren't you, King? You know, I am really surprised that you haven't gone to the commissioner yet. Or even the mayor's office, they're your people.
Cops are my people, sir.
Look, I am telling you, too, that my son has a future.
We believe your son has a drug habit and a deer rifle.
My son was only driving.
A boy is dead.
I don't know. Danny has had problems for years. Ever since their mother died, both Patrick and Danny, they've had trouble. I've done everything I could, everything, to try and keep their records clear. I pulled all sorts of strings, but they're damn friends. Look, I want to know, can you take down his friend and not Danny?
Not as soon as Danny's friend gets himself a lawyer.
They're going to charge him with first-degree murder and conspiracy. What do you think they're going to do to a police captain's son in the state penitentiary? I have dedicated my life to upholding the law. It's the only thing that I ever cared about. That and my sons. Look, maybe I could get him into some kind of a drug treatment program. He's a good boy. He really is. I mean it. It's just he needed more. I don't know. He needed more of my attention. He needed more of my time. He needed more of my.
Paretsky? Paretsky?
You're gonna ruin the finest man that I have ever known. They'll destroy him. And for what, some piece of crap that somebody would have shot sooner or later anyway?
Yaphet Taylor is dead, sir.
A drug dealer on Polish Hill. You think it's worth the trade, Beretsky, the finest cop in the city, for one more nigger pusher up on the hill?
It's never gonna end. When is it ever gonna end?
Huh?
White, black, now even little girls. Vietnamese, Armenian, Salvadorian, Korean. Just people trying to get a foot on the damn ladder. College kid. Mulligan's a good cop. What justice is gonna be served here?
You do the crime, you do the time.
Oh, spare me the cliches, all right? It's easy for you. You're already inside. You were born inside. Nobody is going to accuse you of racial politics or disloyalty. They'll just figure you were doing your job. The mayor's office will protect you. Till next election? Then what? What if the next mayor is Vitali or Chomsky, even Daugherty? What do you think happens to me then?
We get hundreds of drug killings every year. Crack, coke, smack, speed. Solving one more or less isn't gonna make much difference.
You can live with that.
I'll have to. It's your case.
See you on a Monday.
It's one thing to let us interrogate Rufus. As soon as he came out of post op, he started screaming for his lawyer. You get that list of Donnelly's ex-crime partners?
No. They just backed up. They're gonna try to get it to us by Monday.
Hey, King, come on, I'll buy you a beer at the roll call.
Sure.
Listen, a good cop does the job. The chips fall where they fall.
What about Paretsky?
Yeah, sure, why not?
Feel like a beer?
No, it's okay, go on.
We can't go. Thanks anyway.
That was some good police work, King. I'd been proud to put that one down myself.
Thanks, Brannigan.
Not gonna ask you again, you know.
Yeah, well, I hate the roll call. Bunch of drunk cops trying to pinch your ass, you know.
Right.
Nice dress.
So you dropped by to critique my fashion sense?
Computer finally spit out Larry Donnelly's old crime partners. Guess who's tops on the list? Your old friend Rufus.
I'm sorry. Nice dress. How's the leg, Rufus? Hope they ain't giving you nothing for the pain.
Keep her away from me.
You get the name of the guy who shot at me on that rooftop, Rufus?
I told you, I don't know nothing about that. Nothing.
Well, I got two dead black guys in a downtown bathroom. Detective King here is Larry Donnelly, knee-deep in day-old garbage with a hole in his head. All three shot with the same .45. And we've got a little girl missing. Now, the only thing all these seemingly isolated events have in common is you.
We're looking for a reduction of attempted murder charges
here. He emptied a 9mm automatic on us.
Consideration?
No promises.
Go ahead.
Dude got gatted. That's all I gotta say until I know I got a deal.
We're out of here.
Where's little girl, Rufus?
What'd you do, Rufus? Steal from them, you and Donnelly, what?
The guy who shot at you at that bar is named Terry. He and his brother are dealers. Donnelly and me owed him for a shipment that got ripped off. So they grabbed his little girl and tried to kill me. They're bad news. Inbred trailer trash.
The little girl. Is she alive?
Little girl. That ain't right. I got a deal.
Get a beer?
and I got a little paperwork to do. My treat. Come on, we deserve it.
I grew up on the hill. Didn't look like this then. Bobby used to take me to the Polish Club. It was right over there. He'd give me a root beer and sit me down in front of the fights on TV while he played cards. The whole hill smelled of halupka and kielbasa. Old ladies argued on every corner. The mills were still going then. This was a great place to live.
Yeah, well, I've been trying to get out of neighborhoods like this my whole life. College. My parents' expectations. You should have seen my father's face when I told him I wanted to be a cop.
Real happy, I bet, right? This is all I ever wanted to be. Nobody ever helped me. I fought my way in every step. And you're wrong about me, you know. I'm an outsider too, just like you. I'm a woman. The phone rings, they expect me to answer it. Make the coffee, take notes at meetings. Well, who are these men? Who are they to decide? Who are they to keep me out? I'm a good cop, and I belong up here. I earned it.
We did some good today, Peretsky.
Yeah, we did.
Your name's Dorothy, right?
Oh. Dottie.
Anita.
Yeah, I know.
It's the beginning.